Hello everyone. In this video, we'll discuss about the moment of inertia of some regular bodies. So if we consider a ring, the whole mass of the ring is concentrated towards its circumference, right? So if m is the mass of the ring and we consider this axis of rotation, so this is rotating like this. So this axis of rotation is the axis passing through center and perpendicular to its plane, right? So what will be the diagram? This will be the diagram. This is the ring and it is rotating like this. So the formula in this case is that the moment of inertia is mr square. If I talk about this rotation, if this ring is rotating like this, right? So this is another rotation. We can take it to be rotating like this also. So if it is rotating like this, this is the rotation about the diameter. So it is rotating about the diameter. For diameter case, I'm telling you the formula. So in this case, the ring is rotating about diameter. So the diagram is, this is the ring and it is rotating like this. So the formula is I is equal to mr square by 2. Now we talk about disc. Disc means, you can take this as disc. So again for disc, if we consider this axis, the moment of inertia will be different. Now you tell me, if the disc and the ring of the same radius and same mass are there, that means some of the mass of the rim, suppose I want to convert the same mass into a disc, I'll have to take some mass from the rim and shift it towards the center in order to make it disc, right? So moment of inertia will increase or decrease? For the same mass, the moment of inertia will decrease because some mass particles are near the axis of rotation. If distance from the axis of rotation is less, the moment of inertia is less. So disc, here also we will take first case as axis passing through center and perpendicular to its plane. So again the diagram is this, but this is the disc. So your moment of inertia about the axis is half mr square. If we talk about this axis, which is diametrically, so that means it is rotating like this again. Now it is rotating about the diameter. So for diameter, so this will be about the diameter. So this will be I is equal to 1 by 4 mr square. We talk about sphere, solid sphere. You just have to learn these. Solid sphere about diameter. What will be the diagram? It will be a solid sphere. So this will be I is equal to 2 by 5 mr square. If we talk about hollow sphere, so hollow sphere is again we are finding about diameter. So this will be then we have solid cylinder about an axis passing along its length at its center. About an axis passing through its center along length. So what will be our diagram? The diagram will be, this is solid cylinder, no? So solid cylinder means we are talking about this. If we cut the solid cylinder into parts, it will give us discs, and we have the same axis of rotation, so it has same moment of inertia as that of disc, right? If we talk about hollow cylinder, so if we cut a hollow cylinder, we will get ring, right? So again, the hollow cylinder will have the same moment of inertia as that of ring. So I hope these values you are able to remember. You'll have to remember for the questions. That's all for now. Have a nice day.